And I try to hear, okay, we'll give you this visa. Don't be telling me in 4 to 6 what in 4 to 6 you're telling me no.
They can't tell
it's
you
a
that.
Long time. So she's like, okay, so this, that, da, 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 da. I'm like, okay. I did. Okay, yeah, she asked me if I was learning German. I'm like, yeah, I mean, I use this app called, I'm not going to say the name, it's not sponsored. No, I won't call the name, but I use this app, I'm learning, you know, basic, but my program is 100% in English. Mm-hmm. And she says, okay. So she gives me that, and then I left. Pretty much, it was not that straightforward, because that question they asked me, heat. I was sweating in the cold, because remember, it was morning, January, like it's Hamatan, so morning is cold. I sweated. Now heard from people later on that it doesn't necessarily take 4 to 6 weeks, that it could be less.
Really?
Yes.
So it took me more.
So they were like, if I wait till 3 weeks and I had not gotten any information from them, I should send, because there was an application number on that slip that I was given, I should send an email with that application number saying that I wanted like status updates on my visa.
Mm-hmm.
So I waited 3 weeks, there was literally nothing from them. And I was panicking because other people were telling me, oh, I got my own in 3 weeks. Ah, in 1 month, I got mine. I was just like, but they said it's 4 to 6 weeks. They said, don't wait. Like, you Nigerian people don't like to wait. So I started sweating. I sent this email to them.
Are you serious?
And then that was 3 weeks later. I sent the email to them. And after sending the email, I waited. And then I got an email that says that I should bring my passport. I should bring travel insurance. Yeah, I should bring my passport, my travel insurance, and the date of intended travel. And that was it. Next day, I walked into Ambassador's office, bought travel insurance with my passport, put dates that I wanted to travel. I went to the embassy.
Okay, you went
to the
embassy.
I was in Lagos, so mm-hmm. Yes, I went to the, normally you can ship it to them.
Mm.
So I just went to the embassy, submitted it at the gate. I didn't have to enter inside,
mm-hmm.
And then submitted it at the gate. And I think 2 days later, I went back to Port Harcourt, and in like 4 days,
they sent you
my passport and all my documents, and that was it. I had my visa.
Stress. Guys,
no stress.
Anyway, the thing is, we had like very different, okay, not 100% different, but yeah, but quite different experiences. Okay, so for me, I applied from China. Yeah, and then did you go to the consulate or to the embassy itself? Because I know they usually have the German consulate and then the
German embassy. German consulate is in Abuja. Then it's the embassy that is in Asha went that thing in Lagos, the one in Lagos. I don't know. There are two. One is Abuja, one is I went to that thing that is in Lagos, whatever it is, I don't know.
Okay. So for me, I went to the embassy Gonggong in Shanghai, in Beijing. Because I know that they have the embassy in Shanghai, and they mm-hmm. have the one in Beijing. But then normally they'll tell you to go to the one that's closest to you. And the one that was closest to me was the one in Beijing. So they have the German consulate and the German embassy. Please, when you're going for this, you should go to the German embassy, not the consulate. Because you have to do the interview, of course. So when I got to it was in the morning, my dear. I traveled from my city to Beijing. I think it was I came with the night before, because it was an interview, I needed to be prepared. So I stayed with my friend in Beijing. MJ, if you're watching this, thank you so much for hosting me. Like, I'm always going to have whenever I have to travel to, whenever I have to go to embassies and the rest. Yeah, so I was always staying with her. So I went to the embassy that morning, and the way the place is situated is a little bit, it's not, you can't use bus to enter there, so we had to walk, because I don't have car now, you know, people should buy me car. But but I had to walk. It was quite a distance. And then like where it is, there are different countries embassies there. I saw a lot of countries embassies. So if you have an interview and you're walking and you're not seeing any embassy around there, please, maybe you're going to a different place. You have to I'm sure that I saw the embassy of Senegal there.
Yeah,
yeah. So okay. on the road, yeah. So when we got there are other people that are coming to, you know, apply for their own visas as well, and we're all waiting. I think my appointment was by 9-ish, but I was there by 8:30-ish, because, you know, we have to be on time. Yeah, so when I got there, before you even come into the embassy, the security guys were, they will ask you, are you, do you have all your money, do you have everything? If you don't have, go to the ATM. There's an ATM around, because if you enter, this one is not, I want to go out and I forgot to buy chewing gum, I forgot to withdraw money, I forgot. Once you enter, you've entered. If you leave, you have left. If you
do appointment,
honestly, if you feel like you want to do something and you don't have everything ready, and you leave, you have to book a whole new appointment. And believe me, to get an appointment is so difficult. Like, you have to wait for a very, because you know, people want to travel. You're not the only one that wants to travel. Yeah. So by the time you check, maybe the appointment for the whole month is already booked.
Mm-hmm.
You now have to check for a free one. And who knows when you're traveling, it's supposed to be. So you have to make use of that opportunity you already have. So when you check, and it's not just about having the money, you also have to have change.
this German about change is important.
You have to have change because
very necessary.
So when we finally got in, the place was actually quite, it was nice, but it was small, you know. I was expecting maybe a very big, but it was very, very small. It was very cozy, kind of. So we got in, we took our numbers, because of course your number will be shown, like you go somewhere and then you take a card, like, how do you say it? Like, you go and then they print a number for you. Yeah. Yes. Mm-hmm. Depend, you know, in a queue kind of, yeah, for you take your own number. Yeah. So, and then you not check on the screen when you know your number is being called, blah, blah, blah. When they call your number, you go to the windows and they attend to you there.
Mm-hmm.
So, when they called my own number, I went to the first window. So, the lady that took my document, she saw everything I had with me and made sure that, okay, everything was complete. When I finished from there, you know, she kept asking me to my school, because I was already in school, right? And I was coming to tell her I'm going to another school too. And you know, sometimes again, they want to find out why you're doing this course. Why do you want to do this course? That was also part of my interview question. But let me just keep that just to one side. So she took my document. She looked through everything. She was sure everything was okay. And you know, before I went there, it's always better to go with everything and more
extra.
Yeah, because sometimes there's some things that they won't say on the website, probably because your case is different. Because for me now, I applied as a Nigerian in China. So there's some things that they'll ask a Chinese person to bring that I didn't have. You get? So what I did was that I first of all looked at the website of what they wanted from a Nigerian. Yeah.
Okay.
So I came with all those documents, even though they were not required for the Chinese. Especially when it comes to WAEC, I had to print my WAEC certificate.
Mm-hmm.
Although they didn't ask for a WAEC certificate in the Chinese website. So I had to go to a Nigerian website, brought everything there and gave them, because you don't want to have a second experience of going and coming back. So I went, I showed them everything. It was, you know, she looked at it and she's like, okay, everything is okay. And then she now directed me to where I was going to have the interview. She told me I should just wait for like 10 to 15 minutes. I was going to have an interview. The person that interviewed me was this very gorgeous German lady. It was my first time seeing, you know, a German. And she was so beautiful. Oh, I still remember her face. I was going to this country. We have entered. And she was so nice. And she didn't ask me a lot of questions, so she just asked me, okay, so you're studying Chinese, and why are you going to Germany to study international business? And I had to give her a story of my life, how I feel like the German business industry.
You will become a preacher, guys.
You have to speak very intelligent, because you cannot just be telling them, I just applied to school and you want. No, you have to be very strategic.
I just want a certificate. No, everybody wants it. A lot of people want a certificate. Why
should you get that
opportunity?
Yeah.
You have to
be very strategic. So I told them that, see, I'm already studying business, so I need something like that can back. Sorry, I was already studying languages, Chinese, and I had like a degree in English, right? So I needed to have something that would back it up well, so that when I present my case, you know, you will get it very, very. Imagine coming to you like as a business, how would I say, as a business person, right?
Person.
And I can speak Chinese, English, you know, you will give me
you
more.
You already know what it is. You get like the whole Chinese market, like you know that.
So I just explained that to her, and then she was like, okay, yes. And then she now asked me for my certificate, like this enrollment letter, to show that I was already enrolled in school.
Yeah.
So I gave it to her, and she now saw it, and she saw that I had a scholarship. I had like a 20% scholarship from my school because the school fees was there. Hey,
more chest pain.
So I needed that scholarship. Oh, yeah. Hey. So she now said, she was like, okay, you have a 20% scholarship. I told her yes. She now said, okay, fine. She now asked for the blocked account thing. I'm going to sponsor myself and the rest. Mm-hmm. So I gave her my blocked account. She looked at it. She was like, okay. And felt that it was okay and there was no problem. And she didn't ask me a lot of questions. It was just like.
Wonder if you talk about political. But
she didn't ask me anything regarding Germany because, to be quite honest, I had no idea. I didn't even prepare for that. I was like, okay, I'm going to talk about Berlin is in Germany.
Berlin, no, it's in Kapanchan. It's in Kapanchan. What?
I just came like normal, prepared, like nothing out of the extraordinary, nothing like politics and no. But I knew the basics now. Yeah. You know, just ask me like very basic questions, how long you're going to stay and how you're going to sponsor yourself. And I explained all those things to her. So it was very much easy. And I'm wondering, a German was asking me this thing, and a Nigerian was asking me all these plenty things.
I think that's the thing. For a German, it's more like they kind of really know it. Like they're very well grounded. So they don't necessarily have to ask you those deep questions for them to try to get you through to be convinced about what your intent. But for a Nigerian, it's more like they're looking at you like, I'm a Nigerian too. What I know that you feel a lie.
Yes.
So it's more like they want to drill you for you to convince them. So I think that was why I had that whole situation. And honestly, thinking about it now, that I could say that when they asked me what I knew about them, I said that they are known for potato and sausages. I am stupid. I agree, so stupid. So you want to go to a country and the only thing is that they eat potato and like, are you stupid? Are you stupid? But God, like, it's God though. So, honestly, if it was me, I won't even give myself the visa because I don't have sense.
No, what do you just think about it? They are known for curry bones now.
Yeah, like that's what I'm saying. Sausages and potatoes. It's not the only thing
that I'm bread.
I'm bread. So I did my research. So
please, don't beat yourself up. You tried.
Thank you.
But the good thing is that at least I didn't have all this stress. Imagine. I didn't have all this stress at all. Yeah. So after the interview, it was just a very short term. I was expecting more, but it didn't.
Someone was too prepared. She was looking for more. I'm looking for less.
Expecting more. She was like, okay, fine. And then she told me, of course, you're going to get me the visa. They're going to give me 6 weeks. Oh. But they took my passport though.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, they took my passport and I didn't do any UPS courier bag thing. Okay. Because most of the embassies in China. They have this alliance with some of the courier services.
Yeah.
Yeah, in the country as well. So you didn't mean that you just pay for it.
So you pay there.
Yes, you know, yes.
I mean, like, thinking about it, DHL is a German company, but they don't want you to pay them and then they pay your own thing, because pretty much the courier services just come there every day, I think, or they don't know. I don't know how many, because the times that I went to that embassy, I always saw like the DHL bus come there to pick up parcels, which of course are people's documents and passports, and then they take it. So it's more like they know you've sorted it out. This, you just come, take it and go. We have no business with it. So I think that's what they were trying to do.
No, for us in China, it was like a whole different thing. We didn't even imagine going to look for Korea. We didn't even do that.
How much did you pay like for the courier services?
For the courier service, I think it was like 68 yen or so. Then for the visa itself, it was like 650 something yen. I can't really remember that was what it was like. And then at the end, she said that has took like 3 weeks.
Much 4 weeks. Yeah.
Yeah. After the third week, she sent
them an email. Yeah.
For me, I remember very well because I had to leave. I was told to leave China because I was already graduated.